The objective of our survey was to determine what was more popular, Mexican or American Coke. So for that, let's go to the Coke Institute of Statistics. Let's go. All right, so now that we are here, let's first go over to Ian, and he will tell us how it was done.
For our study, we'll be using a single blind test. The way that we'll do that is use two identical cups filled about a quarter of the way with Mexican and American Coca-Cola. To distinguish them, we have a full circle under the cup for Mexican Coca-Cola and half a circle under the other cup for American Coca-Cola. This way we can prevent any bias based on prior opinions comparing the two.
All right, Ian, thank you for that. Now that we're back at the Koch Institute for Statistics, let's go over to the official statistical whiteboard so that we can start to make some sense of all this stuff.
All right, so the first thing we go over is what our population is. So since this is a Koch survey, then our population will be defined as all who drink it. So now that we have our population, since we can't interview or survey all of those people, we have to take a small sample. So our sample was whoever we want it to be. That being said, we wanted it to be whoever was easiest to sample. So that introduces our first error. Our first error, we can start with undercover. What is this? Well, this is when you undercover your population. So undercoverage would result because we're not surveying all our population. Instead, we're only surveying neighbors, classmates, and family. So that's our first error, undercover. Another error that could influence our results would be non-response. But in our case, since we are surveying about Coke, and when we survey them, we give them Coke, non-response is essentially everyone that we asked to be in our survey participated. So do we have undercoverage? Yes, we do. Do we have non-response? Well, the obvious answer is no, because everyone participated in our survey that we asked them. Response bias, that's essentially gone because we single-blinded this test. So, response bias is non-existent because their response as to what they preferred was solely based on taste, not on previous knowledge or bias. So, response bias is done. The wording of our question could influence it. But in our case, all three of our interviewers, Kyle, Ian, and myself, we all asked the same exact question reading from a script. And our question would not support any bias. So do we have wording bias? No. Voluntary response is the next source of possible error. This is when someone feels so strongly about an issue, such as Mexican Coke versus American Coke in our case, that they want to come and participate in our survey. For example, when we told Ms. Yarbrough that our survey was going to involve giving people Coke, she immediately told us that she wanted to be part of our survey. I don't know why, but she did. That would be an example of voluntary response. So do we have voluntary response bias? Yes, we do. Another source of error for this survey. Response bias. Okay. Next topic on the agenda is convenience sampling. I already talked a little bit about this. We only ask people that it would make it easy for us to ask. For example, people already know. A parent, Ian's parents, Kyle's parents, family, classmates, some of you guys who we ask, and my neighbors, for example. We're in a crunch for some last minute data, neighbors outside playing, here, have some Coke, and they were happy to participate. So we have what we in statistics like to call convenience sampling. I think that's how it's spelled. So the reason for this is that we interviewed these people, neighbors, classmates, family. Had we covered everyone, then convenience sampling would not have been an issue. Had we done an SRS, or a simple random sample, and assigned the numbers to every single person out of our population, then convenience sampling would not have been an issue. But we didn't, so it's an issue.
Okay, so then the next thing we have to talk about is the response, or when we're actually doing this statistical survey. Blinding. We had to do blinding in our tests because if we didn't, then people might draw on their previous knowledge of their preferences of Mexican Coke, for example, or American Coke, to respond to our survey. We didn't want that to happen. In addition, so we had blinding, and it helps us in our survey to make it more reliable. So then, the next thing we had to do was drink water. Between the drinks of Coke, we had them drink 3 times the Coke volume so that they would clean out their tongue or mouth or whatever, so that the taste of the whatever Coke they tried would not affect their taste of the following Coke. So we had them clean their palates. I'm pretty sure that's spelled wrong, but who cares? And this also helps us. So don't think that our survey is completely wrong. It does have some good things. And no, that's bad. That was good. And I think that's about it. So yeah. Now, let us observe how Kyle and Ian demonstrate how not to do the survey correctly.
Taste test with Mexican Coca-Cola and American Coca-Cola. Alright, which one did you like better?
I like this Mexican Coca-Cola in the bottom.
Okay, and on a scale of 1 to 10, how do you rate it?
10.
Okay, thank you.
Which one do you prefer?
Coca-Cola.
Which one?
American. That
okay.
One.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how much did you like that one?
A lot.
Seriously.
9?
9? Okay, great.
Okay, so the next thing that we have to talk about is statistical significance. And that is... Well, you guys know how to spell it. Statistical. Significance. Okay, so for now, let's do a report on the statistical significance of our survey. And for that, Kyle will be helping us.
Let's show that 22 out of 32 people prefer Mexican Coke over American Coke. The average rating for Mexican Coke is approximately 8.05, while the average rating for American Coke is 7.5. In response to statistical significance where an observed effect is so large that it rarely occurs by chance, our results show that people prefer the Mexican version of Coke over the American version of Coke.
Back to you. All right, so now to sum up, some final calculations. According to my calculations, people like Mexican Coke more than they like American. So what you should do with this information now is go out to your nearest Mexican store, probably in Fontana, and buy yourself some Mexican Coke, see what they're all talking about.